In the goods shed, the wagons have already been unloaded and reloaded with goods for the main line, ready for departure in the Warrington Dalham Lane through goods. The shunter is hard at it, preparing the Warrington train. The ex-Heaton Mersey wagons have to be moved to clear the yard for marshalling. The empty meat van is well travelled and will return empty over the moors to Hawick in the Scottish Borders on the North British Railway's windswept Waverley route from Carlisle to Edinburgh Waverley. In the steam shed, the Great Central 060 is joining the water column queue, ready to depart on its next turn. Back in the yard, the train is being remarshalled to bring the meat van and the Great Northern van together at the front of the train. The reason for this additional work is because the two vans are vacuum brake fitted and can be connected to the locomotive, and so a vacuum braked engine is required for this service. On this occasion, however, there are only two fitted vans rather than the required four, so the express goods train must run as the slower classification of through goods. The next train to arrive is another express freight, also running as a through goods, the 945 from Edge Hill. The shunter is quick off the mark to remove the Edge Hill train to the yard. He only has 10 minutes to dispose of the Edge Hill train and shunt the Warrington train into the correct position for departure. The engine's lamp code is set to light engine, one lamp in the centre of the buffer beam. The fireman will add a lamp to the top of the smoke box to denote a through goods. This lamp arrangement, always known to the engineman as an upper and a downer. Now that the yard is clear, the shunter can relax a little, and after a brew, can get on with preparing the coal delivery shunt to the mission sidings and disposing of the Edge Hill train. In the station, the road is set for the 10:15 Kenyon Junction motor train to depart. Thank you.